Hello students, good afternoon. Yesterday we have done photosynthesis and different materials that is used for the photosynthesis process. This we have done. Now yesterday I have given some homework. Then this MCQ question try to do yourself. Today I am telling again answer of this question. If there you have doubt in any question. First, process of the digestion, absorption, utilization of food by the body is called digestion, absorption, assimilation, nutrition. That is answer of this question, nutrition. Second part, green plants are called heterotrophs, autotrophs and heterotrophs and sporophyte. Then answer of this question, autotrophs. Green plants are called autotrophs because they can make their food on self. Next, the leaves of the plant are green because they contain ribosome, nucleus, chlorophyll and mitochondria. Then answer of this question will be chlorophyll. Due to the presence of the chlorophyll in the leaves of the plant, then color are green. Which of the following gases is released during photosynthesis? Then answer of this question will be oxygen. Because for photosynthesis, plant are taking carbon dioxide and water, and after this process, then in presence of the chlorophyll and the sunlight, they release oxygen and make food. Next question, carbon dioxide gas enter the leaves of a plant through. Then this question, carbon dioxide gas enters inside the leaves of the plant through the stomata. Up to this we have done. Now this last part of the this one left sunlight. The green plant synthesize food in presence of the food. Chlorophyll present in the green leaves trap the solar energy, and the solar energy converted into the chemical energy by the process of the photosynthesis. The chemical energy is stored in form of the carbohydrate in plant, and leaves of the plant grow in different patterns so as to catch the maximum amount of the sunlight. Now these are the necessary material that is used for the photosynthesis, that is H2O, water, carbon dioxide, chlorophyll and the sunlight. Next we will do aquatic plant like hydrilla, water lily and the vallisneria take carbon dioxide dissolved in water to prepare their food, and they carry out oxygen during this process. Now next our topic, importance of the photosynthesis. What are the importance? Why there is a necessary of photosynthesis? First is the importance, that is the enable green plant to make their own food. By the photosynthesis, green plant making their own food. Without that, in absence of the photosynthesis, they can't do like this. They can't make food. Next, survival of the animal in the world is directly and indirectly depend upon the food made by the plant. Next, our importance that oxygen. Oxygen is the releasing from this carbon dioxide from this photosynthesis process that is the necessary for all living organisms. So, this photosynthesis process is the necessary. Because during this photosynthesis, oxygen is the releasing that we are taking. If we will not take oxygen, then we can't live. That's why this one is the important. These are the three importance of the photosynthesis. Now, after this one, plant also synthesize protein and fats. Plant not only making carbohydrate, but also making protein and fat. Because there we have learned plant synthesize carbohydrate through the process of the photosynthesis. Plant can synthesize other components of food such as protein, fats. Protein are the substances which contain nitrogen. Proteins are the substances which contain nitrogen. But that plant are not taking nitrogen directly. They are taking nitrogen in the soluble form. That is the soluble form inside the water. How they are taking, this one we will read. Plant can't use the nitrogen present in the atmosphere. They need nitrogen in a soluble form. So as a certain bacteria called rhizobium bacteria, with help of this bacteria, then nitrogen will dissolve inside the water, and this water is we are using inside the soil. Then from the soil, then plant roots will take that water, and from this help of the water, then nitrate will be go inside the plant. Then also fertilizer are the rich in the nitrogen. In fertilizer that we are giving to the soil, that also rich amount means more amount in the nitrogen. Plant absorb nitrogen from this fertilizer. Next, certain plants like sunflower and the mustard convert simple carbohydrate glucose into soil into oil and store them in the their seeds. That certain plants, some plants like sunflower and mustard store their glucose into the oil, for example, in the seeds like sunflower, mustard. Plants also synthesize vitamins. Vitamins are found in vegetable, fruits and cereal. Now next topic our came, heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In last we have done autotrophic mode of nutrition. For example, green plant. Green plant will follow the autotrophic nutrition, and this how they are making food by using the photosynthesis process. Now we will read heterotrophic mode of nutrition. There is a different part of this nutrition, spherotrophic, parasitic nutrition and the symbiosis nutrition. And there is a first we will do saprophyte nutrition. There is a some plant which do not have chlorophyll. Heterotrophic mode of nutrition means that mode of nutrition in this plant depend upon the other plants like human beings, animals and some non-green plant also depend upon the other plants. There are the some plant which do not have chlorophyll. They can't synthesize their food like humans, animals and such non-green plant depend upon the food produced by some by other green plant. These are called the heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Let us study in detail how these heterotrophic plant drive their nutrition. Now first is a spherotrophic nutrition. Some non-green plant obtain their nutrition from decay and dead organic matters of plants. Then this one is important. What is a spherotrophic nutrition? That is the type of the nutrition of non-green plant that obtained their food from decay and dead organic matter of plant and animal. Such plant are usually white in color and have no leaves at all. Now what is spherotrophic nutrition? This one is a mode of nutrition in which non-green plant obtained their nutrition from dead and decaying organic matter of plant and animal is called the spherotrophic nutrition. And plant which use the spherotrophic mode of nutrition are called spherophytes. For example, Indian pipes and coral root. These are the example of the spherotrophic nutrition. And what is nutrition? This nutrition that by which that non-green plant will take nutrition from dead and decay material. Then that is known as the spherotrophic nutrition. The root of the spherophyte contain organisms called fungi. And this fungi secrete digestive juice on the dead and decaying matter and convert into a liquid that is used as a nutrient by non-green plants. Fungi and bacteria are known as the spherotrophs. Fungi were easier considered to be plant, but due to the presence of some characteristic different from plants, they are no longer considered as plants. They form an entirely different category of organisms, are considered as a separate kingdom. Now next, there is a next MC question are given. So this one is a homework, try to do yourself. Now some I am telling, the chlorophyll trap the solar energy and convert into that which type of energy? This we have done. Then so try to do yourself, which of there is not necessary for photosynthesis? Carbon dioxide, water, oxygen and sunlight. This also we have done, that which is the necessary component for the photosynthesis and which one is the not necessary. Which of the following is the spherotroph? This today we have done that rose, coral root and neem and mango. Which one is the spherotroph? Now next question, in the absence of the photosynthesis, there would be no blank on the earth. In absence of the photosynthesis, which one can't live on earth, that plant, animals, living organisms, air. Next question, which of the following is not a heterotroph? Then Indian pipe, coral root, neem, and both A and B. These questions, this your homework, this try to do yourself. If there is any problem, then we will discuss tomorrow. Okay, thank you.